Hey YouTube, I want to take a minute to show you my portable solar power generator that I recently built. I want to thank all of the folks who posted their projects on YouTube. Previously, they were great inspirations for this one. I would consider this a medium-sized and moderately priced portable solar power generator. It generates 110 amp hours, cost including the 100 watt solar panel that's used with it, about $950 total cost. It's portable, but I will tell you it's not meant for backpacking. It weighs about 90 pounds. This particular unit I built to use on my cruising boat. I wanted something that was portable so that when I sold the boat and upgraded, I could take the system out and take it with me. I also do some tent camping and it'll be used for that purpose as well. The system offers, again, 110 amp hours. Obviously the starting point is to get some power into this, so for demo purposes today I'm using a small 27 watt solar panel, and I'll show you how all this mates up and the whole thing works. Coming around to the back of the system, you'll see what I've installed is a 2-pin SAE port that allows the energy from the solar panel to come into the system. And once that is coming into the system, it's going to a solar charge controller that is under the top, and we'll get back to that in just a bit. The case itself is a Plano sportsman's case. It was about $25. It is quite rugged. It is much more sturdy than a typical Rubbermaid container by all means, but was quite affordable. And again, it's going to be used inside of a cabin on a boat, so it doesn't need to be perfectly weatherproof, but this is, I think, quite weatherproof as it's built. Again, there's no casters on it because I don't want it rolling around inside the deck of my boat. On the front, after we get some power into the batteries, we're able to provide power through a number of accessory ports. We've got 12 volt on this side. I did install a 12 volt power indicator. It's reading about 13.4 volts going in right now. We've got USB power here, a 5 volt 1 amp and a 5 volt 2.1 amp USB port. Of course, a 12 volt outlet here. And on the AC side, what I've installed, you'll see how that works in a bit, is a AC volt meter and amp meter, and that gives me an indication that power is on here, and also is very important because the amp meter tells me how many amps I'm drawing out of the system using various appliances, and that's very important when you're developing your solar power budget for solar power generated during the day versus solar power being utilized from the system. I've installed some Leviton weatherproof covers to my 110 AC outlets here. And swinging back around to the back side, what I'll show you is that this is all turned on using a master battery switch that's been installed here. It is keyed, so we'll install that key and power up the AC side of the system. You'll see here that when you turn that switch on, it does power up a digital thermometer. There's a sensor inside that tells me what the internal temperature of the case is, so we can monitor whether or not I need to activate the fans. There's two fans on the back that push air in and draw air out of the case to keep the AC-DC inverter cool. They are powered up if needed by this switch, and we'll turn that off so that we can better hear each other. But I only use that if it is absolutely necessary, and that helps to conserve some power. So back to the front side of the case again. What you'll see is that now our AC voltmeter and ammeter is powered up, indicating that there is power again to these outlets. Right now showing 109 volts and 0 amps being drawn. Let's go to the inside of the case. The case, again, is pretty rugged. Nice top with some handles that latch it down. You can remove this top completely. And on the inside, what you're going to see is a 400 watt pure sine wave inverter and a 30 amp solar charge controller on the deck, if you will, or on this tray that keeps these appliances or these accessories up out of the battery compartment. I've installed also an emergency light that could be useful during camping if absolutely necessary. There's handles here that allow me to take this tray out. Again, this idea was inspired by another YouTuber who was so good to post his project. Very inspirational. I've got four vents here that allow air to circulate through the top portion of the case as well as through the bottom. I'm going to show you how this whole thing comes apart and what the inside looks like. We simply need to disconnect the AC power cord from the top tray, and the whole thing can be lifted out and put behind the unit. I've basically used two batteries. They are wired in parallel to two AWG wire cables here to transfer that power back and forth between the batteries. I installed a divider and something of a deck, if you will, underneath as well. There's some framing that'll keep the batteries in place and keep them from moving around. The wire gauges here range from smallest 18 gauge right up to the 2 gauge and quite a few different wire sizes in between. I modeled this system again after a number I've seen on YouTube. I did consult with a friend who is an electrical engineer for safety purposes to make sure everything was going to be wired properly and safe and to protect all of the components. There's probably no less than about 5 different fuses in this system, ranging from ANL 50 amp fuses here between the inverter and the battery, and a host of other inline fuses, such as this one. There'd be a 30 amp fuse between the solar charge controller and the batteries. There's a number of other fuses running in the lines between power sources, AC, DC, and outlets. I didn't mention there's another way to charge this system up. I did buy a trickle charger that had an SAE port. Simply ran the cable that came with that through the wall of this case and then out and under the handle so that this is protected from the elements. And again, an SAE 2-pin port mates up here to trickle charge this whole system so that it's ready to go in the event of an emergency. Again, it generates 110 amp hours, costs about $950, and I'm going to be really excited to use this again with a 100 watt panel. This should allow to charge at a rate of about 5 amp hours. So that is my YouTube project. I hope everybody enjoyed it. And again, thank everybody who posted on their projects so that we could benefit from their knowledge and build our own.